Hi, everybody, and welcome to True Wants, where here we try to help you make that decision if it's going to change from a want to a need. If you are new to my channel, I really hope you will choose to subscribe. It's free and it's easy. It's the red button you'll see right underneath this video. If you press it and it turns gray, you are in. It's that simple. There's also a bell beside the subscribe button that I always recommend that you press. It's called the notification bell. And what ends up happening is YouTube will notify you just once that I have uploaded a brand new video. I do upload a lot, and sometimes my videos are time sensitive, so I don't want you to miss out. So make sure to press that subscribe button, ring the bell, and you'll be in the know. Also, right underneath in the video, there is a thumbs up. If you press it, it will turn blue, the number will increase, and that's you helping me grow on the YouTube platform. So I'm thanking you in advance for doing that for me. Supposedly, YouTube says that if you get a lot of those thumbs up, they'll then take your videos and put them in front of other people that just haven't had the opportunity to meet you yet, but they do enjoy this type of content. So it helps in what they call the algorithm for, you know, you're helping YouTube find me. So thanking you in advance for doing that. My growth has really been the type that it has been solely word of mouth, and a lot of people finding me through Instagram and things like that. So I thank everybody for sharing my channel and telling people about me, because I'm here to share. That's why I started this channel. It was to learn social media as well as share deals that I find, as well as the boxes, as you know, the companies that I chose to purchase from, like BoxyCharm and Ipsy, as they grew, because when I started my channel, it really just was one bag and one box. So as they're growing and the add-ons are growing, and we're all getting so much product that just from those two companies, the other few that I have that are coming my way have been really unique and fun. But I know a lot of girls have their channels where all they do is source out boxes, buy boxes, get boxes sent to them, and so on and so forth. It's a real ride, the beauty community. So this has been a lot of fun to be able to share with you the products that I found, but it has been such a pleasure getting these boxes, because we're able to explore in them. And then when I don't, like, I budget myself every month a certain amount, and if I have a little bit left over, I end up going to the shopper in Ipsy to see if there's anything, because the shopper every day in Ipsy, I tell you guys all the time, at 9 a.m., I go in. I used to do it religiously, not so much anymore, but they change, they keep adding, and they keep it alive for, they come up with a new deal every day. And then in that deal, they end up keeping it for as long as, I think, a week, and then it will disappear, or it sells out before that, you know, the week. But they also have so many deals during the month where there's all these bundles that I share with you guys, between the add-ons, the flash sales, the pop-up sales, a custom kit. You know, there's just so many. So you really don't need to always go into the shopper. But the shopper always has some really unique deals. And like I said, they usually disappear and things like that. So they also now put in the shopper where they're dividing it up into even categories that it's not just makeup, it's like foundations and you know, complexion and things like that. So I always like to look to see what foundations they're looking at and getting into, because a lot of times you're able to get some of these higher end foundations at a discounted price through an Ipsy, you know, a shopper. And that's what I ended up doing. So what happened the day that I looked, there was one that I've been wanting, and I've been keeping it on my wants list for a little while. And I was hoping that either the price was going to go down or my budget was already too much for that month. And finally, I was able to get it. But the day that I was planning on buying that one, when I went in, there was another foundation in there that was priced, I think, incorrectly. And it was a shade that I felt was going to be close enough for me. So I sat down and I grabbed that one. And then I waited a couple of days to buy the other one, because I wasn't going to get two foundations in the same month. And then I still had, and I said, oh, I should get it. And then I'm happy that I did, because when I went recently into the shopper, because it takes a while for the products to get here anyways, you know, in the shipping. And when it came in, I went to look up to confirm like what I paid and all that stuff. And my color that I ended up choosing ended up selling out on the one that I initially wanted. So it ended up working in my favor that I hesitated not too long, that I ended up getting both. But both to me are fantastic deals, and I want to share them with you right now, because if it's a color that that I got is not your color and you have a different skin tone, then I'm telling you to look in the shopper and go down to where they have it divided up into the complexions if you're looking for foundations, because that's where I found these. So the first one that I'm talking about is from Makeup Forever. Years ago, I tried this when it was really, really hot, and it was way before boxes, and I think I ended up paying 40 or 45, and in Canada, everything is a lot more expensive than here. So if it's 40 here, it's like 50 or 55, you know, in Canada. So it's just because of the dollars and the exchange and you know, duties and all that stuff. So this one here is the one that I ended up getting. And what I mean by this is, I think this is a $40 US foundation, and they have it in the shopper for around 23, which is a great deal. It's almost 50% off. This one in this color was $12 and something. So I said, and it's free ship always in the shopper, doesn't matter what you buy. So really, really excited. So the color that I ended up choosing is R330. And I went on the Makeup Forever website to try to see, you know, some of the swatches to try to make, you know, an educated decision. But as I tell you all the time, if it's at least in, you know, somewhere in the category, to me, if it's a little too light, I can bronzer it up. If it's a little too dark, you can always mix it with a lighter foundation. But I always like to try the foundations first for their own merit. And I don't always, you know, film my foundations and stuff like that. So I get to play and see, you know, if it works for me or if it doesn't work for me. And then if it does, I sit down here and I share it with you guys. And this one did. This is a very lightweight foundation. And what's great about it, it's saying it's a medium to full coverage. And it says it's created for the very latest high definition technology of the film TV industry. It's Ultra HD advanced formula to look invisible on 4K camera. Even to the naked eye, is perfect for the makeup pros and also for you. And they're saying it has a 4D complex and it's really, you know, all that. But what I liked about this was you got coverage and you don't feel like you're wearing anything on your skin. So I'm gonna pump this out to you. And as I've shared with you in the past before, I use my Maybelline Fit Me loose setting powders. To me, they're dupes for the Laura Mercier's, but I'm able to buy them in multiple colors by getting an inexpensive loose powder. I'll also leave my Amazon links to that Maybelline Fit Me, because I find it's the cheapest on Amazon, far cheaper than all the other stores. I also have a link to that, and by you purchasing through the link, I also will make a small little commission. I don't know how much I'm not part of that world of, you know, the commissions that come in, but what I do know is that if they don't get used, they disappear. So to be able to share that with you, it helps me out to be able to have an Amazon link on my channel. So if you're interested, I will leave the Maybelline Fit Me powders in there, because those, to me, I wouldn't share with you a link unless I felt it was beneficial to you and the cost was beneficial to you. So if you're finding out about it through me, it's a nice thing to do is to use the link. So this here is the color of this foundation, and it is called R330. And to me, I really wasn't sure, like the Y I thought would be a yellow tone, the R I thought would be more like the cooler tone. So when I swatch on my hand, I got a good bruise here. I don't know from what. So I don't, when I put it on, if I find it's a little bit too dark when you put it on your face, I end up playing with those loose setting powders from the Maybelline Fit Me. So I have one in fair light, I have one in light, and I have one in light medium. They also run, to me, one shade too dark. So to me, the light acts more like a light medium, and the light medium acts more like a medium. So just so you know when you're looking. But with Amazon, even if you purchase something and it's not what you wanted, it's an easy return as well. So to me, that's why I like always checking the prices on Amazon. And if they are the cheapest, I like to share that with you guys. And that's why I wanted to have an Amazon link. So that's the one here. And like I said, this is lightweight. You do not feel like it's on your skin at all. This ended up being fantastic. I mean, a steal for $12 to try it. And like I said, if the deal is there and it's a foundation that you like, there's so many ways that you can play to get the color to match you. And that's what I do. I have lighter foundations. They also have some also drops. I think NYX has them that you can put in this whitening to make it lighter and things like that. But you can always play with powders to help you with that as well. So really, this impressed me. I remember using it years ago and it was fantastic. I think I ended up discarding it when it was like down to almost the end. It just was too old to keep anymore. So really happy to be able to have this back in my inventory. The other one that ended up being one that I really wanted, and when it first came out, I really wanted it. And the same thing happened with the beauty blenders. finally with the beauty blenders, I bit the bullet and I bought a few at, you know, $20 because they never went on sale anywhere. And then all of a sudden on Ipsy, they had a duo, which was a beauty blender with the foundation. So the foundation on its own is also like a $40 foundation, and the beauty blender is around a $20 value. So to me, I think I paid for both $25, and it's free shipping. So this was an absolute steal. If you've never tried a beauty blender, and if you're more into that than the foundation, this is a winning combination. The beauty blender by far is fantastic. They're the one that changed the entire beauty industry and introduced us all to makeup sponges. And I'm telling you, it has changed the makeup game for me 100%. So if you haven't had the opportunity to try it, this is an absolute steal, you know, with that being attached to their foundation. This foundation was on my radar early on when it came out, because everyone who reviewed it, no matter if they were dry skin or oily, and I'm a combo girl, but I have a lot of dry patches and things like that, so I really feel I have a good way of testing foundations because I have dry spots, oily spots, and normal spots. Go be me. So this is the one that I ended up getting, and the color that I got was in the 2.40, and I chose it in neutral. I always like to choose neutral, and if you're not familiar with choosing foundations, if they're yellow or cool, or the yellow tones are usually if your veins are green, and they say you look good in silver, in gold jewelry. If your veins are more blue, that means you are cool toned and you look better in silver jewelry. If you have a mixture of green veins and blue veins and you look good in both gold and silver, which I feel that's who I am, then you're neutral. And that's why I always try to choose neutral. So that's what this one is here. So let me just do a quick pump of this out here. Oh, the other thing about this that is really, really cool, there is a lock on here. So this is also fantastic to travel with too. And then on the other side is almost those trays, because a lot of girls like to put their foundation on a tray and then take it from the tray and bounce their beauty blender on. So they made it so that the tray is right in the foundation. It's really beautiful. So they didn't miss anything. So you have a lock button, you have the tray, and you have the actual foundation. And what I ended up doing was I used my beauty blenders, because I own beauty blenders, and then I put a little bit on directly onto the sponge so it doesn't end up getting on here. But other girls like to use it that way. And then I take it from there and then I place it on my hand here. So on my face, I mean. So this here is the color that it is here. And it really is a beautiful, beautiful match for me. It blended into my skin tone beautifully. And I was really, really happy with everything about it. Also very lightweight, gave me the full coverage, buildable without it getting cakey, still kept that beautiful same foundation. I think this is the one I'm wearing today on here. I ended up darkening it up later because we were going somewhere and I wanted to darken up, so I put my Smashbox powder foundation on it that is more of a light medium. So I don't want to say this is the color because it's not at this point when I'm filming this, but really, really beautiful. And then they come this small, and then when you wet them, they become really a really nice size. And that's the two foundations that I wanted to share with you that I was able to pick up in the shopper. The other sponge that I always like to tell you guys about is from Juno & Co. This is the one that I use all the time. It is a microfiber. These are only $5. And I have a link for Juno & Co. where you can get a 15% discount on their website. They were one of the first companies that reached out to me, but I was using their product way before they did. And like I said, I only share with you what I use, and those discounts work for me the same way they work for you. So I love being able to get them. So this one here is the Juno & Co. This is their original. They have it in a bunch of different colors. The different colors are different densities. There's another one that I use that has more of a reddish pink tone. That's one that I use. It's a lot less dense than this one. This one I never use wet. I always use it as my powder. I dip into whatever it is, and then during the day, I leave it in my my area so that when I want to just, you know, if I'm getting a little oily during the day, the powder from the day, I don't add any more. It's already on the sponge. And these wash out so, so beautifully. And they never go into the actual sponge. So I really highly, highly recommend these for $5. And that's everything I wanted to share with you guys today. So please share with me if you've tried these foundations and if you enjoy them also. And if you check the shopper as often as I do to see what those deals are, and if you've picked up anything that you think we should all keep our eyes on too, I would love to know that in the comments down below. And that's it for today. So Take care, everybody. Stay well, and I will see you all soon in my next video. Bye for now.